In this video, we will try to understand how to calculate maximum bending moment and bending stress. This question we have taken from GATE 2010 question paper. A massless beam has a loading pattern as shown in the figure. The beam is of rectangular cross section with a width of 30 mm and height of 100 mm. Now we have to find out the maximum bending moment occurs at. So we have to find out what is the location of maximum bending moment and the maximum magnitude of bending stress. So we can say that over here at A and C there will be reactions RA and RC. Then this is the UDL of 3000 Newton per meter. So uniformly distributed load of 3000 Newton per meter length is given over a length of BC and the length is given as 2000 mm. Now here the UDL is of Newton per meter. So we'll convert this 2000 mm into meter. So it is 2 meter that we have shown over here. Similarly, this 2000 mm that also we have converted into meter, that is 2 meter. Now, as it is a rectangular distribution, we'll convert this uniformly distributed load into point load. So it is 3000 Newton per meter. So for 1 meter length, the load acting is 3000. Then for 2 meter length, what will be the load that is acting? So it is 3000 into 2, that is 6000 or 6 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. And it will be acting at the center of 2 meter length because it is a rectangular distribution. So center will act at the center of this particular 2 meter length, that is 1 meter. Now our first job is to calculate these reactions RA and RC. So we'll apply the conditions of equilibrium. Summation of forces in y direction is equal to 0. We'll consider upward forces positive and downward forces negative. RA and RC, they are acting in the upward direction, so they are positive, whereas 6 into 10 raised to 3 or 6000, that is acting in the downward direction, so that is negative. Therefore, we can say that RA plus RC is equal to 6 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Now we'll apply the another condition of equilibrium, that is summation of moments is equal to 0, clockwise positive and anticlockwise negative. Now we'll take moments about point A. We'll start with RC. This RC, the arrow of this RC will be producing anticlockwise moment about A. So it is negative. And perpendicular distance between C and A is this 2 plus 2, that is 4. So it is minus RC into 4. Whereas this uniformly distributed load, which we have converted into point load, will produce the clockwise moment about point A. So it is 6 into 10 raised to 3. And the total distance from this point up to point A will be 1 plus 2, that is 3. Now transfer this negative term on the other side. So it is RC into 4 is equal to 6 into 10 raised to 3 into 3. Or we can say that RC will be equal to 4500 Newton. Now we can substitute this value of RC in equation 1. So that we'll get the value of RA. So RA will be equal to 6 into 10 raised to 3 minus RC. So RA will be equal to 6 into 10 raised to 3. Value of RC is 4500. So therefore RA will be equal to 1500 Newton. Now you consider any section XX at a distance of X from point A because we have to find out what will be the location of maximum bending moment. Now if this distance is X and this distance is 2 meter, then the remaining distance will be X minus 2 meter. And the UDL for this particular length, that is from B up to this section XX, will be 3000 into X minus 2 because 3000 Newton per meter and length is now X minus 2. And this will be acting at the center of X minus 2. So it will be X minus 2 upon 2. Now we'll take the moment about this particular section XX. Now this RA will produce the clockwise moment about this section XX. So it is RA into X. Whereas this UDL of 3000 into X minus 2, this arrow will produce anticlockwise moment about this section XX. So load is 3000 into X minus 2 upon 2. 3000 divided by 2, that is 1500, and X minus 2 into X minus 2, that is X minus 2 square. Now we have to find out the location of maximum bending moment and the maximum bending moment. So we'll differentiate this MXX with respect to X and equate it to 0. So derivative of mxx, and value of mxx is 1500x minus 1500x minus 2 bracket square, and we have equated it to 0. Now derivative of x with respect to x is 1, and derivative of x minus 2 square is 2 times x minus 2. So we can transfer this negative term on the other side, so it will become positive. Now cancel out this 1500 and 1500, so it is 1 is equal to 2 into x minus 2. Transfer this 2 on this side, so it is 1 upon 2 is equal to x minus 2, or 0.5, 1 upon 2 is 0.5. Transfer this minus 2 on this side, so it is plus 2 is equal to x. So therefore x is equal to 2.5 meter from A, or 2500 mm from A. So that is our first answer. Now we have to find out the maximum bending stress. So for that we will require to find out maximum bending moment. Now substitute this value of x is equal to 2.5 in this equation of mxx. So in place of x it is 2.5 that we have substituted. Here also in place of x we have substituted 2.5. So the value that we have obtained is 3375 newton meter, or 3375 into 1000 newton mm. Now we know that maximum bending stress sigma b is given by m upon z, or maximum bending moment upon z, where z is the section modulus, and by default this particular section modulus is about xx axis, so it is 1 by 6 bd square. So width is given as 30 mm and depth or height is given as 100 mm. So those values we have substituted and we have calculated our second answer. So bending stress is given by 67.5 MPa. So in this way we can find out the location of maximum bending moment, then value of maximum bending moment, that is M max, and maximum bending stress induced in a simply supported beam carrying uniformly distributed load. Thank you very much for watching.